Hey, Jonathan, what's in the inbox today?
Hey, Kim. So we got a really good one today. We have a customer who's using sticky peptides.
Ooh.
And they're concerned about them sticking or non-specific binding to their sample container.
Ah, okay.
And they're writing here, they're thinking that they can just, you know, jack in or dump in a bunch of acetonitrile, and that's going to do the trick.
Well, that's an interesting theory. I mean, acetonitrile would potentially lessen the non-specific binding or losses in the sample container, but, you know, generally peptides start to precipitate around 75% acetonitrile. So this customer would have to be careful with that. I think we could do a really cool experiment.
How do you want to set this one up?
Yeah, I think we can kind of test the boundaries of this. I think we can do an experiment with teriparatide. It's a relatively hydrophobic peptide.
Okay.
We can try a variety of sample containers. So we can look at polypropylene. We can look at a commercially available low binding sample container.
Okay.
And we can look at the Quan recovery vials and plates. And then what we can do is basically see what recovery looks like in different amounts of acetonitrile.
Yeah, I think that'll be really good to show.
Yeah, but I think we should also look at the chromatography. Let's see what the impact is there as well, because ultimately, if this is for quantification, that's what we have to look at, right?
Exactly.
All right, let's go.
All right. So, Kim, how'd the results look from that experiment that we set up?
Sure. Yep. So we ran the three different sample containers. We ran the Quan recovery plate, a polypropylene plate, and a commercially available low binding plate, just for comparison. And we injected the teriparatide, and we looked at the recovery in each of those different sample containers. So as we move from 0% acetonitrile up to 10% and 20% and so on, you can see some real differences in recovery. With the Quan recovery plate, even at 0% acetonitrile, we're getting some recovery of the teriparatide, where we're actually not in the polypropylene or the commercially available plate. As we get up to, you know, more around 10%, we're getting really good recovery in the Quan recovery plate. And we have to get up to about 15 and 25% before we have that kind of recovery in the polypropylene and the other low bind plate.
I see that, Kim. That's great. But my question is, then why not just stick with 30% acetonitrile? That's what I do.
Yeah.
You know, and you can use any plate you want.
Yeah, I mean, it does look like you could just go up to 30% acetonitrile and then it doesn't matter.
Exactly.
Let's take a look what the chromatography looks like.
Oh, cool, Kim. That's some nice chromatography. Can you tell me a little bit more about it?
Sure. When we look at the actual chromatography that happens with those different acetonitrile contents, you can see that at 0% all the way up to about 20%, the teriparatide is completely retained on the column.
Mm-hmm.
But as we get up to 25% and higher, where we would have to go for the other sample containers, the teriparatide is actually starting to break through, and we're getting it in the void volume in that chromatography. And since, you know, traditionally we'd be looking for quantification of this peptide, that's really not going to help us get the result that we need. So we actually need to be at a lower concentration of acetonitrile than 25%.
Yeah, so what I said earlier about just jacking in the acetonitrile up to 30%.
You can't do that. No.
Can't do it. Doesn't work.
So JT, how do you want to call this one?
Yeah, this one's busted. I mean, when dealing with hydrophobic peptides, breakthrough is a big concern. And we saw that in the data.
Yeah, it definitely was in this experiment. I think it just goes to show that you have to consider all the aspects of the chromatography to get good recovery. I mean, this question, they were specifically worried about non-specific binding in the sample container. And I think we showed that you could go up to 30% acetonitrile with any of the sample containers.
Yep.
And get recovery out of the sample container. But the impact of that on the chromatography was that 30% acetonitrile, you had breakthrough of the peptide. So you really need to think about all aspects of the workflow. And here, you know, a careful selection of sample container where you could use lower than 30% acetonitrile actually is beneficial.
Yeah, that's advantageous.
Yep.
So do you want to write this up and get back to the customer?
Yeah, I'll write it.
All right, great.
If you'd like your question to be answered on a future episode, please feel free to email us at trustyoursciencewaters.com.